long ago it was my fate to captivate a widow at Ramsgate.
Why, 'tis odd to state the same at Margate Dido.
By her not liking to be kissed, I thought I'd better try to in the lifeguards of Blues enlist.
How odd, and so did I too.
I was not tall enough, they said.
Too short, they said, of me.
Infantry I entered,
and I the infant me.
My widow offered to purchase my discharge from the marching line. Oh!
That's odd, coincidentally, the very same did my lord.
I hesitated to consent, for my consent she waited. I gave it,
far with mine I went, and never hesitated.
A happy day came near at length, we hoped it would be sunny. I found I needed all my strength to face the ceremony. I suddenly found out I was unworthy to possess her. I told her so at once, because I feared it might distress her. Before the words were out of my mouth, there came from the north and flew to the south a something that came unpleasantly near. Clattering, spattering, battering, shattering, dashing, flashing, smashing, flashing, slashing, crashing, missing or whizzing, I passed my ear. It shattered itself on the mantelpiece, whop.
What was it?
A tremble. The basin called slop. It fell at my feet, it would have put the back of a man who was ever so meek up. So being thus baited, I retaliated and hurled at my widow a groggy teacup.
Between you then, there was a fraction.
And I was threatened with an action.
Or turn, proceed.
One morn, when I had finished my ablution, I took
a walk.
No, sir, a resolution. I tie up my clothes, my shirt and my hose, my socks for my toes, my linen polos. I think of my woes and under the rose, I pack up my bundle and off I goes.
Ah! I see you left in a tiff.
Listen. I solemnly walked to the cliff, and singing a sort of a dulcet dirge, pulled down my bundle upon the verge, heard the wild sea mournful cry, looked all around, there was nobody nigh, none but I on the cliff so high, and all save the sea was bare and dry. And I took one look on the way below, and I raised my hands in an agony throw, and I stood on the edge of the rock so steep, and I gazed like a maniac on the deep. I cried, farewell, farewell to earth, farewell, farewell to the land of my birth, farewell, farewell to my only love, to the sea below and the sky above. With a glance at the sea of wild despair, I cried, I come. My bundle lay there.
Just there?
Yes. At the edge where the coast guard's way was chalked. Then away!
No!
In the opposite way I walked.
What a clever man, what a capital plan. I've listened with attention. I think that I should like to try your wonderful invention.
What a clever man, what a capital plan. You've listened with attention. If you like it, why should you not try my wonderful invention?
Invention. ingenious creature! You disappeared, the suit of clothes was found...
Exactly! And in one of the pockets of the coat, there was also found a piece of paper with these affecting farewell words. This is thy work, O Penelope Ann.
Penelope Ann. Penelope Ann?
Penelope Ann.
Originally widow of William Wiggins.
Widow of William Wiggins.
Proprietor of bathing machines.
Proprietor of bathing machines.
At Margate.
And Ramsgate.
It must be she. And you, sir, you are Box, the lamented long-lost Box.
I am.
And I was about to marry the interesting creature you so cruelly deceived.
Ah, then you are Cox.
I am.
I congratulate you. I give you joy. And now I think I'll go and take a stroll.
No, you don't. I'll not lose sight of you till I've restored you to the arms of your intended.
My intended? You mean your intended?
No, sir, yours.
How can she be my intended now that I'm drowned?
You're no such thing, sir, and I prefer presenting you to Penelope Ann. Permit me, then, to follow the generous impulse of my nature. I give her up to you.
Benevolent being! I wouldn't rob you for the world. Good morning, sir.
Stop!
Unhand me, Hatter, or I shall cast off the lamb and assume the lion.
Pooh!
An insult! You know the consequences, sir. Instant satisfaction, sir.
With all my heart, sir.
Bouncer!
Bouncer! Bouncer!
Who is it, gentlemen?
Pistols for two.
Yes, sir.
Stop! You don't mean to say that you keep loaded firearms in the house?
Oh, no, they're not loaded.
Then produce the murderous weapons instantly.
Harky! Why do you object to marry Penelope Ann?
Because I can't abide her. You'll be happy with her.
Happy? Don't be absurd, sir.
Then don't you be ridiculous, sir.
I can't find the pistols, but I have brought you a letter. It came by the general post yesterday. I'm sure I don't know how I came to forget it, for I put it very carefully in my pocket.
And you've kept it carefully in your pocket. Margate, Penelope Ann.
Dear Mr. Cox, pardon my candor.
But being convinced that our feelings, like our ages, do not reciprocate...
Reciprocate? I hasten to apprise you of my immediate union with...
Mr. Knox!
Hurrah!
Three cheers for Knox.
The little second floor back room is quite ready.
I don't want it.
No more do I.
What shall part us?
What shall tear us asunder?
Box.
Cox! You will excuse the apparent insanity of the remark, but the more I gaze on your features, the more I'm convinced that you're my long-lost brother.
The very observation I was going to make to you.
Oh, tell me, in mercy, tell me. Have you such a thing as a strawberry mark on your left arm?
No.
Then it is he. My hand upon it, join but yours, agree, the house will hold us.
And two good lodges, Bouncer gets, he'll in his arms enfold us.
Rat a pen, 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 pen,